friends, I take this opportunity to welcome you again to this lunch hour. For God loves us and He has given us an opportunity to come and share His word this afternoon. Today we are going to speak about the appointment to service. The appointment to service. And that is our topic today. And I want us to realize if surely God has appointed us, and which category have we been appointed, so that we can serve in the capacity that the Lord has given us to service and to worship Him. Now, whenever we speak about appointed to service, I want us to reconsider our reading in 1 Timothy chapter number 1, verse 12. 1 Timothy chapter number 1, verse 12 to 15. This is what the Bible says in 1 Timothy chapter number 1, verse 12. I thank Christ Jesus our Lord, who has given me strength, that I consider that He considered me trustworthy, appointed me to His service. 13 says, even though I was once a blasphemer and a persecutor and a violent man, I was shown mercy because I acted in ignorance and unbelief. Verse 14 says, the grace of our Lord was poured out on me abundantly, along with the faith and love that are in Christ Jesus. Verse 15 says, He is a trustworthy saying that deserves full acceptance. Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the worst. I want to repeat the last verse, where he says, here is a trustworthy saying that deserves full acceptance. Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the worst. Friends, I want you to realize one of the things that we ought to know whenever we speak about the appointed time or appointed to service. Now, whenever we speak about appointed to service, we are speaking about selection. God's selection to do His call in His vineyard. Now, God has all the capability to select whoever He wants, so that He can do whatever He wants in His vineyard. And before claiming, friends, before claiming that you are a servant of God, know of the following things. There are so many people who claim that they are servants of God, meaning they have been selected by God to serve. Now, whenever you have been called a servant, it means you have been selected by God to serve. And whenever before you choose, or whenever you decide to claim that you have been saved, you have been selected by God to service, I want you to note of the following things. Number one, I want you to note, if are you appointed to serve, or are you born to serve? There is these two statements that ever challenges people's things, people's minds, and people's capacity to serve God whenever they think of service. Now, it is either you think that you have been appointed to serve, or you were born to serve. But the above all are the same. The difference of the languages in the two statements is all about the grammar used, but it all means the same. Either being appointed to serve or being born to serve, it's all the same, because you will have to give yourself as a sacrifice in the service of God, of whom you are not serving yourself, but you are serving your Creator. Now, whether you have been appointed or you have been born as a servant, it's all about God. And this is why Paul is saying that this statement requires praiseworthy and trustworthy, that Christ came for us who are sinners, to be transformed and speak or and serve unto him, so that the world may have as things to speak or to categorize themselves as Christ came for us. Listen, friends, Christ did not come for those that who are righteous. He came to appoint the people who are sinners so that they can do what he used to do. And this is why I was thinking the other time, why did Jesus never choose of great men who were of knowledge, of experience, but he went to choose of fishermen? I realized that most of the people during those days, the fishermen, were not people considered to be worthy in the society. And now Jesus comes to pick unto them and appoints them to be his disciples, and appoints them not to continue to be fishers of fish, but fishers of men. Now, I want you to know the appointment that you have been given in your life by Jesus himself or by God himself, it is of the service of God that is eternal. Therefore, work with the capacity of capability that you are a greater man, because either you have been born to serve or you have been appointed to serve, it's all the same, because it's for the Lord. For anyone, friends, to have the power and the capacity to serve, he must be appointed by God and is done before birth. I want to repeat that statement, that anybody who has ever been appointed to service, even Saul speaks and says that I was once a blasphemer, I was once a prosecutor, but the mercy of God came to me. Now, I want you to know that you are not serving because you were entitled to serve, but God appointed you before birth so that you can serve him in this capacity that you are serving him. Friends, note this. Delays of the starting lines in service depends with the higher and the hierarchy rank of your calling, because we are not the same. Whenever you see a delay in your system of your service, whenever you see the things that are delaying for you to start the service of God, even Jesus himself delayed from 12 years to 30 years, because the hierarchy and the service rank of him was higher than anybody else. Now, whenever you see that the things are delaying in your life, it is not that God has delayed to do something in your life. Now, the appointment that you have for your birthright, that you are going to serve God, it comes with the higher delays depending on the higher capacity that you have to the service of God. Now, the more you carry, the more you are expected to have. Now, the more you dig deeper to look for the things of God. Now, things are delaying in your life, not because you are a sinner, not because you are a blasphemer, but God is taking you through a process. You understand that the hierarchy that you have in service is higher, of a bigger capacity. There you know, you know not to sit idle, but to seek for God more, because we are not the same. When you read in 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 20, the Bible says that in the house of God, there are so many vessels, and these vessels are different. There are vessels of gold, there are vessels of clay, there are vessels of wood, there are vessels of metal, but all are for the system and for the service of God. I want you to know that in the system of God, we have so many. We have the apostles, we have the evangelists, we have the prophets, we have the different kinds of the people. But our system in the service of God has been appointed by God to come into a particular person according to the particular gift that he has deposited in you, according to the appointment that you have in the service. Friends, when you have been appointed to serve, you don't fight the battles of yourself, But God fights the battles and you win through Christ. I've learned this when I read in 1 Corinthians 15 verse 17. The Bible encouraged us by telling us that thanks be to God, for he gives us victory through the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, whenever you have been appointed to serve, in whatever circumstances that you go through, God gives you victory because it is not you who serves, but it is the things that the Lord has deposited in you what serves in you. Note of the following. David in the Bible fought the hardest war and is the only man that the Bible says that he was after the heart of God, just because he knew that he was appointed to be the service provider in the kingdom or in the land of Israel. And out of all that came to the life of David, still he knew that my gift of birth is to serve God, and therefore I'm trusting that my war will be won by God, because he is the one that who has appointed me. When you read in the book of Samuel, chapter number 1, the Bible speaks about the calling of Samuel. When they were living with Eli, and the voice of God came and called unto Samuel, because from the birth, Samuel was appointed to the service and was dedicated by his mother, Hannah, that he'll be a boy of the altar. Now, I want to note something in your life, that you are struggling in your life because you have not yet heard the voice of God that is speaking and reminding you that you are the daughter of the altar, that you are the son of the altar, and you need to go back to the altar and do the appointed thing that the Lord has appointed you for. Because whatever battle that you are going through, you are avoiding the altar. Now, I want you to know that as from today, don't avoid to serve God. Don't be ashamed of the gospel. Don't be ashamed of declaring the servant of God, because you are a person made of an altar, just as Samuel. Number 3, note this. Solomon, from the birth, God has talked to David, the son of Jesse, and told David that your son Solomon will build for me my temple. Now, Solomon was appointed from birth, even before birth, that he will build the temple of the Lord. Now, I'm speaking to the people, but the Lord has selected this afternoon that you have the capability to build the body of Christ, but you are not working and articulating your issue as per the calling. I want you to note this, that God has deposited capacity in you to build the body of the Lord, and therefore you ought to build with vigor. You ought to have the capacity to carry everything and build it, because it has been appointed over you and it is in your system, but the Lord has chosen you to do so. Number 4, the Bible speaks of Jeremiah chapter number 1, as from verse 1, that God speaks to Jeremiah and tells him that before you were made in the womb of your mother, that I, Lord, I knew you, and I knew that you will be my servant. Now, I'm speaking about a people who are being dismayed in the service of God. But before you were being born, God knew you and God selected you. And whatever capacity that you carry in the body of Christ, you don't carry for yourself, because it is a burden that God has deposited upon you, that you carry your own yoke and do the work of God, because God has appointed you from birth. Lastly, Christ was chosen and appointed by God to be the deliverer and the final deliverer of the human race. This was after God was done with the sacrifices of men, with the sacrifices of lamb, with the sacrifices of bulls, with the sacrifices of atonement, with the cleaning sacrifices, with the cleansing sacrifices. Now, God was done until he chose one of his begotten son, that he come to be the appointed sacrifice to cleanse everything for the service of God. Now we can term ourselves to be clean because Christ came and served us. And this is why Paul is saying that I was once a blasphemer. I was once a persecutor. I was once the worst of the worst. But Jesus came, and this is the true and trusted and a well accepted statement, that Christ came for us and we are trusting him because he was appointed to come and re-select us, pull us back so that we can walk on the ways of Jesus Christ. Remember this, friends, that as so you are, so be it in your life, that you have been chosen by God, appointed to service. With the act of service, you have all the capability to do the best in the kingdom of God. As you go back to your places of work, go realizing this, that you have been appointed to service in whatever capacity that you are working in the temple of the Lord, in the service of the body of Christ. You have been appointed, not by right, but from birth, to be the service provider in the kingdom of God. And may God bless you, and may God make that gift occur in your life so that it may sprout and bear fruits in Jesus' name. Until we meet again, let the peace of God cover us together, and shalom.